Nadia, Jet Set Tours PR girl, and today I am kicking off my island hopping tour in southern Thailand. I've literally been waiting for this day all my life, and it's finally here, and I'm so excited. So I'm starting my trip in Phuket, and originally I really didn't want to come to Phuket because I had heard it was just overrun with tourists and travelers, and no one really wants to deal with that. But I'm so glad I did because there are a lot of private islands you can go by private boat around Phuket. Like this one, we're gonna spend the day at Como Beach Club. It is in Koh Naka, in small Naka Island. And here you can snorkel, you can stand on a paddleboard, and kayak, and do all sorts of exciting activities. So let's go. So clear and turquoise all the time, and the sand is super soft, and the parties just don't stop. If drinking alcohol from a bucket sounds exciting to you, then this is your place to shine. And if it doesn't sound exciting to you, then I actually would not recommend coming here because you might be horrified by what you find. About 11 kilometers from the town of Krabi, and after the disaster that is Koh Phi Phi, this is so chill and I'm loving it so much. This beach is particularly beautiful because you have all these luscious green mountains in the back. Right now I am here to catch the sunset, and it is just so serene and peaceful. Everything you need after spending 2 days on a hardcore party island. Another beautiful beach waiting for me. My life is so hard. The best island for last. I'm in Koh Samui, which is the second biggest island in Thailand after Phuket. And Koh Samui is known for having a lot of honeymooners. It's mainly like a romantic getaway destination. So it's like I'm on a honeymoon by myself. But I really can't complain too much because I'm balling out at the Intercontinental Samui in Bantalingyam Resort. It's one of the 1,000 places that you need to see before you die.
the chef and owner of the restaurant. He made me the sea bass that I ate almost all of. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to show you. Can you tell us what's in it?
Yeah, local sea bass. Some coriander put in there, and passion fruit sauce, and some pasta fruit. All local ingredients. We were made to interest. So pretty much the whole idea of the restaurant.
Well, you can't see it now because I destroyed it, but it was so good. I'm obsessed with it. So if you're ever in Koh Samui, come by, make it a point to come here because everything's fresh and the restaurant's amazing. And sadly, this is my last stop in my island hopping trip in Thailand. Two other really famous islands that you could go to are Koh Phangan and Koh Tao, both of which are on the same side of the coast as Koh Samui. Koh Phangan is where the really famous full moon party happens every month, and people will not stop talking about how great Koh Tao is and how cheap the diving is there. So if you have time, you should definitely check it out. Overall, Koh Samui was by far my favorite island in Thailand. It's so laid back, very tropical. You have a lot of options in terms of different beaches to go to because the island is bigger. So if you want the honeymoon of your dreams, then definitely come here. It's really, really fun. Be sure to check out the exclusive features on all the hotels and restaurants that were featured on this video, like Point Yamu by Como, Barracuda, and the Intercontinental Samui, Pantelingam. And yeah, come island hopping in Thailand sometime. It's a lot of fun.